Hi, welcome to the Rittner Floral School in Boston, Mass. I'm Dr. Steve Rittner, and it's a pleasure to welcome you into one of our classrooms today. In today's video, we're going to show you how to make a really cool design for July 4th. I think you guys are really going to enjoy it. Now, as typically in our vase arrangement work, we like to start off with a container, and the look that we're going to be going for in this design today is going to be a cottage look. In other words, a kind of a casual look that could be enjoyed in a beachfront property or a cottage somewhere, maybe in the mountains. In other words, a little more relaxed, a little bit more casual. To do that, we've got a box here. The box is weathered a little bit. It's a very, very pretty box, but it's a plain kind of container that will enable us to come up with a really cool look that's a little bit more of a casual kind of look. I've already prepared this. Now, it is a rather deep box, so I've taken some styrofoam and placed styrofoam in here. And in order to raise up our foam, we have here essentially several of these. These are Lomi number one trays, and I've got two of them, one over here, one over here. I placed a block of foam in each, and this is resting on a styrofoam base. I've already lightly greened the top so that we pretty much have done the prep work enabling us to go and do this design. And I think you're going to find this is one that's going to be fun, and we're going to have an enjoyable time putting all kinds of pretty things together for a lovely design for July 4th. And starting off in our design, let's play with something that I would consider to be a prestige item, our orchids. Aren't these gorgeous? These are Dendrobium orchids, one of my favorite flowers. Dendrobes, of course, come in other colors, but we're going to stay with the red, white, and blue kinds of coloring in today's design because this is going to be something that is geared towards Independence Day, our July 4th. And I'm going to make a line there with it. I'm going to work my way across from the left to the right on this design with other things as well. I have a flower here that I think is really cool. This is called Oryngium. Oryngium. Isn't this an amazing flower? It really, really is cool. It feels like something from a sci-fi movie. These generally are gray to bluish. We picked them because they do have a slightly bluish tinge to them, but I think it is just an interesting flower. I'm going to take one of these, and I'm going to place this in place as well, a little bit lower, a little bit lower. I'm going to work my way across, and I'm going to work next with a flower that definitely is blue and that will work for us for this particular holiday, and that is some of our delphinium. Aren't these beautiful? It's very hard to find a lot of blue flowers when we're doing these kinds of things, but delphinium definitely does it. I like on the delphinium the fact that you have this little almost like inverted trumpet or wizard-like hat. They're very, very pretty and it works really well. And so I'm going to take a couple of my delphinium and I'm going to place them here as well into my base. So I'm gradually working my way across. So I have something tall, something a little shorter, something a little taller. I think that my viewer, I'm going to add a little bit more in terms of the delphinium because it is a very, very pretty flower, but it's not a very thick one. And so I'm going to take and build this up a little bit with perhaps another stem or two of delphinium, and notice that now I have a little bit more thickness on my stem. Now let's see, what other things can I play with? Well, let's see, I'm looking on my side bench where I have a few things. I have some more of the Oryngium. So I'm going to take more of my Oryngium and let's place another little segment of Oryngium right over here. So I have a few more Oryngium placed over to one side. And now I'm starting to run out of space, of course, in terms of this, but I would like to put something over onto the other side. And so I'm going to take another dendrobe and place a dendrobium over here and another shorter one right here. So I've got a couple of dendrobes. So notice, my viewer, that what I'm doing here is I'm starting in the back part of the foam. I'm gradually working from left to right, creating height in my arrangement. Now, let's deal with the front part of the design. We can put some things in the front. And again, this is July 4th. We want to stay with the red, white, and blue theme. There are lots of white flowers. There are lots of red flowers. Blue is a little bit more challenging. The delphinium certainly helps, but I'd like to have something that's going to ground this design a little bit more in terms of almost a focal kind of flower. And I found something that really works very, very well in that capacity. hydrangea. Isn't this a beauty? A blue hydrangea. It is absolutely gorgeous. And so what we're going to do, my viewer, is we're going to take our hydrangea and I'm going to place a hydrangea smack dab right here. And notice how that fills space very, very nicely for me. Now, obviously, I've got a lot more space that I'm going to be dealing with on this design. And so I'm going to take a second hydrangea and I'm going to work a second one over here. So notice that I have one here, I have one here. This one is a little bit more forward. This one's a little bit further back. And that kind of gives me a kind of a cool effect. So far, I've got some things worked towards the back, working from left to right. I've got a couple of hydrangea, one a little more forward, one a little bit more closer to the oryngium. And this is in the bottom part of the design. Now, why don't we connect from here to here and work it all the way across? And we can do that with all kinds of really, really cool things. Now I'm looking at my design bench. What else do I have to play with? Well, I see that I have some pretty nice looking alstroemeria. Alstroemeria, of course, are available throughout the year. They are a wonderful flower. They last very well. They're very durable, but they feel very natural. And I'm going for a natural kind of effect here. The whole effect I want to give here is kind of casual and almost like the design is growing naturally in my garden. And so I'm going to take a little bit of my alstroemeria and I'm going to place some pieces in here. And it almost feels like it's just sprouting out and just kind of growing very, very naturally for me. And I'm going to connect from the back towards the front with a few pieces of my alstro. So this design almost is intended to give a feeling of natural growth, almost like it's something that has been transported from perhaps my garden and we're going to enjoy it. So I've got a little line working here with my alstroemeria. Now, what other mischief can we do? Well, I'm looking at the flowers that I have available here to me, again, on my design bench over to one side, and I have another flower that I really like. This is one of my favorites. This is a miniature Gerbera. Of course, because we're playing with the red, white, and blue of the holiday, I'm going to play with some red mini gerbs, although I certainly can get them in white as well. And we're going to follow the same kind of process that we did a second ago in terms of the alstroemeria. I'm going to take my gerb and I'm going to work it right here. So it's kind of next to my delphinium. But I'm going to gradually work it so that it comes downwards. And I'm deliberately angling it a little in one direction, a little in another direction, so that it is almost going to give me like a little step-like kind of arrangement here. So notice how I'm going from high, gradually coming low, bringing my eye gradually in towards the front and center of the design. So notice how that gradually is filling in here very, very nicely for me. And we're working gradually coming down there. Now that's interesting. Now, what other things can we do? I'm just looking to see what we have. We have, of course, one of our favorite flowers and certainly an important flower. Everybody loves them. We've got some red roses. So I'm going to take some of my red roses and I'm going to work some of my red roses in. So I'm taking one, placing it right there. And I'm going to work another one coming in over here. In other words, I'm starting again at the back part of my design, and I'm just going to gradually work some of my red roses coming in from the back in towards the front. So I'm leading my eye, my viewer, from what we placed in the back part of the design, and I'm just gradually letting these flowers lead us from the back section in towards the front part of the design, giving us a very, very pretty effect. And notice, with a few of our roses, that's done that very, very nicely. Now let's see, what else do we have? Well, we have some of our dendrobiums over here. Let's add a few more things to it. And in order to come up with an interesting effect, I'm going to play with another flower that happens to be one of my favorites that also is available around this time of the year, Snapdragon. Snapdragon is a very, very pretty flower. It is a really, really cool flower. And every time I see this, I can't help but play with it. You know, hello, I am a Snapdragon that does that. Okay, I had my fun. So let's take this and break it down. And I'm going to take my Snapdragon and place one maybe over here. So it really feels like quite a nice mixture of different kinds of stuff that we can get and play with in terms of coming up with an effect. And I placed another one right over there. So that kind of looks kind of cool too. I've got a few more odds and ends of things, and I'm going to work a few odds and ends in. I have, for example, another piece or two of Orangium, and I'm going to just kind of stick it here and there so that the design doesn't feel totally predictable. In other words, one cool thing that you can do on your designing, if you want to come up with an effect that it's got rhythmic flow, yet at the same time you want to kind of break it up a little bit, is we can take some of our flowers and work a little bit here and there so that it doesn't feel like it's all one thing. You got a little of something else tucked in here and there. So a little bit of our dendrobiums worked in here, and then I'm going to sneak a little bit more of our dendrobes right over on this side. So you'll notice, my viewer, a little here, a little there, it kind of gives an interesting effect, and it doesn't feel quite as regular on it. I could stop at this point if we wanted to, but wait, there's more. Let's play with it just a little bit more. Again, I'm going for a casual look on this design, and one way that we can give it a little bit more of a casual look is just to sneak in a little of this stuff we call here at Rittner's Stephen Hare. But the technical name when you look for it in your sources is, of course, Spanish moss. And in order to hold it in place, I'm going to hold it with a little piece or two of hairpin. And we've got hairpins made with a little piece of wire in a kind of upside down U with a number 20 wire. And that gives us the ability to hold it in place. By working a little Spanish moss in, it feels a little less formal and gives kind of an interesting effect. Now, not everybody likes that effect. If you like it, use it. If you don't like it, of course, you don't have to use it, but it's another option. Another way that we can create a little bit less formality in our design, and we like to get this kind of an effect these days, is we can always take a little bit of our branchy stuff. I like using branchy stuff, and notice that by working a little bit of branchy stuff in, this adds a little bit more of an informal feel to our design, and we can work some of this in here and there. Again, it's not for everybody. Not everybody likes branchy stuff. I tend to like it. I think it's interesting, and I think it gives us a counterbalance when we put some of this stuff in to the more linear aspects to it. So what do you think, my viewer? Quick, easy, and fun. That's the Rittner Floral School way. And you'll notice that by taking some of our flowers, working a few going across in the back, then placing some things in deeper into the front, and then working from the back into the front with things like our roses, our gerbera, our alstomeria, and then a few things just to break it up a little, we can come up with something that's quick, easy, and fun, and definitely has a July 4th theme. Keep in mind, my viewer, the same approach that I've used here could be used at any time throughout the year. What makes this specifically a July 4th design is obviously the use of the red, white, and blue. However, I'm sure you can see, my viewer, how you can take other color combinations, mix it together, and have an arrangement that could be used virtually at any time of the year for your home or for your friends. I hope, my viewer, that you've enjoyed this. Here at Rittner's Floral School, we believe that floral designing should be quick, easy, and fun. And by all means, keep viewing some of these videos that we have, and even come here and take a class, because we have all kinds of hands-on workshop courses here at Rittner's Floral School. On behalf of all of us here at Rittner's Floral School in Boston, I'm Dr. Steve Rittner. We hope you have a great July 4th, and thank you for coming in and visiting with us today.